All right, now in this video, we will talk about how to generate HMI screens within the PLC. So you can see in my hardware, there is no HMI device here, but we can create HMI screen within the PLC, and using this application, you can also view this HMI in your browser. So you don't need any screen, you can connect any computer, open the browser, put the IP address, and you can view the HMI. So that's very easy. So let's see how we can do that. So if you go to the HMI web server, we have the HMI web server inside. And if you open this one, there is no application at the moment. So we right-click on the application and click Add HMI page. Okay, so when you click that, you will see two pages. One is login and one is a page. Login is that you have to log in to the HMI before you view it or make some changes. And in the page, you can design what you want to see. So this is the main page. So I will right-click this one and make it as Set HMI Page as Startup. So when the HMI start, I want this to be as my startup page. So I will click this one and then I will open the page. Now in this page, I want to show some, let's say what we have in the PLC. We have this buttons A, B and X, and then you have digital IOs, input 0, 1, output 0. So let's talk about the digital variables at the moment, okay? So what we're gonna do is instead of turning on A and B from this logic, we will do it externally in the HMI. So in this case, the first step is I go to the variables. And I see these are my local variables. Usage is just the local. I want to make it external so that I can link it with my HMI. Okay. This you don't have to do it. This is by default like this. So I will first make it external. External. All three are external. And now I go to my PLC and check the data list. Now here you have, let's see, when we made this external, we have A, B, and X. Okay. So what I will do is I will right click here and say add HMI tag. So it will add A by default, it will take the name from here. And similarly for B and for X. So we have three tags for the local variables. So now I will go to my digital IOs and do the same. So output 0, add HMI tag, and input 0, and input 1 and input 0. So now I have six variables, okay? Let's go to the main page now, and here. So let's create the HMI page. Now let's see, we want to press this A and B as a button, okay? So I will go to, if you see this part, if you see this HMI 33, wait a second. Yeah, here you see button, okay? So you have to drag this button on the screen. Now you have this button here, okay? Now, you can change the property of this button. For example, if I double click this one, I can change the text. So let's say I will type just A, because this is my A variable. So you can write any text you want. And on the right side, you will see the properties. For example, if you see the text, you can change the text, like I put A here. You can change its font, you can change its margin or direction. You can change the position of your button and its shape as well. You can define the color of the button. For example, when it is not pressed, this will be a gray. When this is pressed, it will be a little bit blue. And I will make it, let's say, a green. This looks much better. And you can also put an image inside this button. That's also possible. So these are the different properties you can change for this button. But the main thing which we want to do is, I'll just close this one. You have to go to behavior. How does this button behave? So this is the main part, variable. That's where we do the tagging. So we have already defined the tags. We have defined the tags here, HMI tags. So these tags you will be able to see here in variables. So now you can see here A, B, X. So I would prefer to click here first. So I go to A. So I got my variable A here, okay? Now this is the latching. I will tell you what does it mean. So let's just try this button A, which is tagged to my A input in the PLC. And let's just try to simulate that in this case. So what I will do is I will close this one. Mm-hmm. And I go to download, write and start project. So this will download my project into the PLC. So let's just wait for a while. This is downloading. Waiting for the controller to start. Okay, now I will go to application and click launch HMI simulator. So I will just work on the simulator. Later I'll show you how to open it with the IP address. Now you can see that it asks for user and password. So I will enter my admin details. So this password is generally written on the PLC. If you have changed it, then you will put the changed password. Otherwise, if you don't know the password, this is what it's written on your PLC. So I will log in. Now this is my A. So when I press, this is green, which is actuating A. So let's see that as well. So I will split the screen. Go to, oh, this I want here. Main code. Wait, I can basically open this one. Bring it here. So now you can see this is my A. And that's the button A. So when I press this one, this gets true. Because this is momentary, that's what the next step is, the latching. And this is the AND gate. So I prefer to make this button latch so that when I press it, it stays on all the time until I press it again. So I'll go back to my, I will close the simulator, go back to my page, and the button where I have defined is here. And first I go offline. And this button I will enable latching. All right. So now let's take another button. I will just copy paste this one, quite easy. Name it as B and quickly tag this variable as B. So I have now two buttons. Okay. I prefer to put some text here. That's more nice way to display. So for the text, you can go on the bottom on the HMI, and here you have a text. Just drag it here and double click, and I would like to write inputs. Okay. These are my inputs. And I can copy paste this one. And I can write local IOs, input outputs. So this is my input. Let's just try this one, and then I will show you how to display the output. So write and start project again. So wait a couple of few seconds. This is going to download, and then we open the simulator again. Download it, launch HMI simulator, split the screen, open the main, bring it here. Perfect. I will log in again. Okay, now you can see if I press, I can't zoom in the screen. Anyways, when I press A, this remains true, B remains true, and X is true. So these two were my inputs. Now I want to display if X is true, I need another indication. How we can do that? It's also quite simple. So I will just go offline. And now there we need an output, so I will put a text first of all. Output. Now what we do is we see we have buttons, checkbox, ellipse. This is what we need. Okay, so take this one out. It's a round kind of LED. You can adjust the size here. So this was my output X. I would like to put a symbol here. So this was my X. Maybe something like this. Now if you see here, there is no variable mentioned anywhere. Where do I put the variable? This is a kind of confusing. What should I do? So what you do is you go to the dynamics of this button. So click on the dynamics and add a new dynamic. So in here you can define if you want to change the shape, change the visibility, if it should blink, change its translation, horizontal, its movement, whatever you want, you can do that. So in this case, I would prefer to just change its color. So I will go to dynamics, color or fill. I will go for fill. Now when I do for fill, I have a variable. So let's use the variable in the web server as X, okay? Now, since I have the variable, I can choose if this is false, what should be the color? If it's true, what should be the color? So for false, this is fine. For true, I would take again green. That's it. That's it, how you want to do it. So this is my output. So let's try this one, write and start project. So just remember, you have to change the dynamics. That's it. So I will write and wait for a few seconds. And again, I'll go to simulator. HMI, launch simulator. Split the screen. Open the monitoring. Bring it here. Log in again. So A, B, and X. So this represent this output X. Okay. So this is what we were doing with the local variables. You can do similar ways for your digital IOs, which is on the PLC. So this will now be very easy because we have already one variable here, so we have to just duplicate that. So I will write here instead of local IOs, prefer to copy. I will write PLC IOs. Oops, copy these guys here. And IN0. Copy paste IN1 and copy paste out 0. Looks good. We just have to tag it now. So IN0. I prefer to use the same colors. So let's go to HMI web server, input 0, IN1, input 1, out 0, output 0. That's it. So we will check it now. So these were your local IOs and these are your PLC IOs. That's the difference. Start project. So I hope this is very easy. You just have to drag drop the object, define the dynamics, put the tag. That's it. That's how you create simple HMIs. For sure, there are many other things you can do. So we will see in the next video how to do with the analog IOs. So let's go to now HMI application launch simulator. Now I can show you. Let me log in. Like this is how I logged in. Now I will make my camera for IOs a little bit bigger. Okay, so this AB, you know, it's coming from the local variables. This IN01 coming from the PLC. So this is my input 0, which is turned on. That's input. Oops, that's 2. That's input 1, which turns on output 0. If you want to see that in the programming, I can show you here. Here. So this was AB and also working. These are your digital inputs. Input 0 is here, input 1 is here, and out 0 is here. Sorry. Yeah, now you can see input 0. This is input 0. This is input 1, and logic is true, so output is true, out 0 is here. Okay, this is also on the PLC, you can see this is input 0, and this is input 1 in the LED, and that's output 0. Alright, so that's how you can monitor your digital IOs or your local variables in the HMI. Okay, if you have any question, you can put a comment. In the next video, we'll see how to do it with the analog IOs. So we can see the potentiometer reading, we can also give the output analog output from the HMI directly. So let's see that in the next video.